This video covers the button layout of the DPVR P1 Pro EDU headset and controller, explains each button's functions, and shows you how to adjust the headset straps for a comfortable fit on your head. Using the headset in a proper environment is very important. Make sure you are sitting down or have at least 3 feet of empty space around you before using the DPVR P1 Pro EDU headset. Additionally, do not walk around while wearing the headset. Direct sunlight will damage the headset lenses and screen. Do not use the headset outside or leave the device sitting in direct sunlight. The controller itself is used like a laser pointer inside the virtual interface to point at elements you want to interact with. A virtual controller is displayed inside the interface and is useful for finding where a button is located without having to remove the headset. Press the home button at any time to return to the main interface. Holding the home button down for 2 seconds will recenter the virtual interface to your current viewpoint. Press and hold the home button for 5 seconds to turn the controller on or off. The large button on the controller is used to activate buttons inside the virtual interface, just like a mouse click. The surface of this button is also a touchpad that can be used for other actions, such as scrolling through lists. The return button is used to step backward to previous screens, just like the back button on a smartphone or tablet. Some apps will use the trigger button on the back of the controller for interactions instead of the large touchpad button. The indicator light on the controller will flash quickly when the controller is low on power. The light will flash slowly if the controller is powered on but not connected to the headset. Press and hold the home and return buttons together to pair the controller to the headset. The white indicator light will turn off once the controller has fully connected. The right side of the headset has a large touchpad that functions the same as the one on the controller. There is also a return button below the touchpad on the bottom of the headset. If a controller is not connected to the headset, turn your head to position the cursor inside the virtual interface and tap the touchpad on the side of the headset to activate buttons. Press the return button on the headset to step backward to previous screens. The power button is on the left side of the headset. The status indicator light next to the power button is blue when the headset is powered on. The light will turn red when the headset battery is low. A yellow light is displayed while the headset is charging, and it will turn green once the device is fully charged. To charge the headset, connect the included charging cable to the micro USB port on the left side of the headset. Then connect the other end of the cable to a power outlet using the USB power adapter. The left side of the headset also has an audio port for connecting headphones to the device. Audio volume control buttons are located on the bottom left side of the headset. The bottom of the headset has a small microphone in the center and a micro SD card slot for expanding the available storage. The headset also includes built-in speakers behind the face cushion on both sides of the headset. Place the headset on your face and put the rear strap behind your head. Pull apart the closure tabs, adjust the straps on both sides of the headset for a tight, comfortable fit, and secure the closure tabs in place. If needed, the strap on top of the headset can be adjusted as well. For more information, watch our other videos about Lenovo VR Classroom or visit lenovo.com/VR Classroom. For guides and documentation, visit support.lenovo.com/VR Classroom.